A team of scientists just published a paper where they explained how the recently launched James Webb Space Telescope is capable of finding alien worlds with developed agriculture. Isn't that fascinating? You can find the link to that paper in the description below. The only life we know so far is here on Earth, but people have always tried to find it somewhere else, be it in the form of microscopic organisms or intelligent civilizations. Our ancestors have been around for about 6 million years, but modern Homo sapiens evolved about 200,000 years ago in Africa. However, the true civilization of humankind began about 10,000 years ago, when for the first time ever, farming appeared on Earth and humans switched from hunter-gatherers to agriculture. Humans learned to use natural resources to produce commodities that maintain life, and cities started to emerge. This, in turn, changed the way Earth looked. The same might happen in other worlds out there, but we never had the technology to witness something like that, at least until now. Scientists are optimistic that we might soon detect exofarms on distant planets, and now that Webb Telescope has been successfully deployed, it will help aid the search. The Space Observatory contains cutting-edge technologies such as the gigantic mirror and ultra-sensitive detectors, which will help us examine many unexplored exoplanets moving around their parent stars. If something like photosynthesis is occurring on a particular exoplanet, then the farming of plants would produce recognizable signatures as it does on our planet. According to the new paper, the cultivation of plants requires a planet with active hydrological and carbon cycles, and depends on the availability of nitrogen in the soil. About 78% of Earth's atmosphere is made up of nitrogen. But since atmospheric N2 is a very stable molecule, it's kind of hard to give plants access to it. That's why the use of nitrogen fertilizers is crucial in agriculture to increase production. It helps plants get more access to nitrogen, and this process leads to the release of greenhouse gases such as ammonia and nitrous oxide. The new study suggests Webb Telescope could detect the presence of these gases in the atmosphere of an exoplanet, which could serve as a remotely detectable spectral signature of technology. Since ammonia falls back to the ground in a matter of days on an Earth-sized planet, this would indicate an ongoing agricultural activity. But unlike ammonia, nitrous oxide can continue to exist in the atmosphere for more than 100 years. This greenhouse gas is also a byproduct of combustion, but the authors of the study assume that other civilizations may discover, just like us, that combustion is not sustainable and phase it out. So, this can also be an indicator of agricultural activity. But there's another greenhouse gas, methane, emitted by agriculture, rice agriculture, and ruminant ranching in particular, as well as from biomass burning, landfills, and energy use. And this could be another signature worth looking for. About 70% of methane comes from human activities, and it just keeps increasing. That's extremely bad for our climate, as methane has accounted for about 30% of global warming since pre-industrial times. All in all, possible signatures of agriculture could only occur on a planet that already supports photosynthesis. And Webb's sharp infrared eyes are powerful enough to scan exoplanet atmospheres with enough sensitivity to confirm water, oxygen, and carbon dioxide, along with traces of ammonia and nitrous oxide, all of which are technosignatures for extraterrestrial agriculture. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.